Okay, this is Adam. This is my fourth and final lesson on speed for the contemporary blues harmonica player. Okay, we were working on this little riff. Remember my basic principle? Speed it up slowly. You're trying to get that. It's this test, it's the prototype vehicle, right? That's what you're doing when you try a new lick fast. Get it up to speed, find where it falls apart, back off just below that point. Work on it. If you need to back a little bit more below that point, work on it. Make sure your foot's keeping the groove. If you're trying for 16th notes, and that's really what I'm talking about here, remember it's four notes per beat. So if you can't move on the harp at all, at least you can just do four notes on a beat using your tongue. Ta 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 ta. In fact, that's not bad, you know, as a little kind of warm-up routine, just to, again, why would you do this? Well, you know why? Why would you practice something like that? Not because it's music, but because there's going to come a moment in a solo when suddenly you're going to reach into your bag of tricks. And that particular trick's going to be there. And as I said, I'm going to put up a video, or I've already put up a video, of me reaching into my bag of tricks for, and I'm going to show you, the mystery riff. What's he doing there in the middle of Heartbreak? This is what I'm doing, right? And I can't, that was in real time, and this is just a lesson. What I did was I went from one draw, to two draw, to four draw, to six blow, to eight draw, to nine blow. In interval terms, I'm going fifth, root, fifth, octave, fifth, octave. And I'm doing it so that the one draw is a lead into the two draw. This is the beat. One, two, three, four. Up. Now that's speed of a very different kind. It's not about lightning machine guns. What it's about is a kind of breathtaking octave leap on the blues harp. Now, how would you use that? Well, I didn't even worry about that when I practice it. It's something I try to practice. But it was there in this particular solo that I did in Heartbreak. Obviously, once you practice this, I used to practice this kind of stuff when I was doing. I remember going to see Sonny Rollins, the jazz sax player, and he went. And that was his riff. Two, three, four. You hear my beat? And I would do that. And then I would gliss up to the nine blow. Now, has any harmonica method that you've come across, any blues harmonica method, suggested that you do these fifth leaps, these leaps of a fifth or a fourth? I don't think so. Maybe they're starting to. Anyway, I hope maybe they'll play catch up with Gussow here. I think this stuff is. We got a tiny little instrument. It's almost a joke instrument, right? You got to work much harder to pull something out of it. So at the very least, I'm just trying to use the old noggin, right? At the very least, you got to use holes 1 all the way up to hole 10. If overblows are there, just because little Walter didn't know about them doesn't mean you shouldn't use them. Now we know about them. That's welcome to the year 2008. Welcome to the year 1987 when I started doing them. I mean, they're here, you know? They're here, they're, have no fear, get used to it, but, right? So octave leaps, or why not? Why not? So you heard what I did with it. Why not? Why not? It's something to throw in. What I want to produce in you, and certainly when I watched the video, produced it in me, it was like the, as we say, the WTF moment, the what the moment. That's what I want to produce. The what was that? Not the, doesn't he sound just like little Walter? You know, good if you can do it, great if you can do it. I'm not interested in that. anymore. I was when I was a much younger man. I'm not interested anymore. I'm interested in having you guys come along and try to sound like me, or producing you to the point where people are coming along trying to sound like you. If I can do that, I have done what I want to do. Okay, a little free play. What do I do when I just free play? Well, I got a choice. I got a choice if I'm working on fast stuff. I got the patterns. As 16th note patterns. Ah, here's something else. Which was... How about that? I love that kind of motion. How about doing the blues scale and moving down on it, but do it by a stepwise move up? How about going 5-draw to 6-blow, 4-draw to 5-draw, 4-blow to 4-draw, blue third to 4-blow, 2-draw to blue third. All right, how about that's as 16th notes. Or 8th notes. How about triplets? Didn't quite get it. Has any, except for Jason, has any harmonica teacher on the web or in your hometown or in the big city you go to come at you with something like that? No, it's not a harmonica riff. It's Stanley Turrentine. I mean, it's straight Stanley Turrentine. You know, with any sort of hoots and whoops on a sax, okay? But it's blues scale. It's right there for us, guys. It's right there for us. And so, why not? It's hard to do. For me, it's hard to execute that stuff. But I still practice it. Find a speed. So I'm going 1, 2, 3, 2, 2, 3, 4, 2, 3. Hey, while I'm at it, you know what? I've got just one tiny little bit of time left. Check this out. Check this out. C harp, first position, blues scale, in the middle octave. I went back to my old evil cross harp ways. I think that's the next frontier is really to blow first position playing wide open, because there's all of that overblow stuff, and just do the blue scale. I'm sure Jason's done this. I haven't worked it out, but you know, it's right there for the taking, guys. Make it, it's not my thing, really. Make it your thing. I gotta go. Are we out of time? We're out of time. This is over. It's been fun. Probably more to say about high notes. Talk to you soon. I'm out of battery juice, out of time. See you down the road. And look for the Satan and Adam videos. We're coming to a town near you. We're coming to the Arkansas Jazz and Heritage Festival, October 11th. See you there. And Nashville on the 10th. See you. Bye-bye.